Happening, guys. Jonathan here, aka Crazy Shadow 303, here with another, I don't know if you can really call it a match vlog, on Crazy Shadow Talks Football, because like I said in previous videos for this season, it's going to be a lot different than it was last season. It's not going to be a case of simply doing a match vlog, because today, 12:30, back at the Hawthorns, finally back, and it's a game against Leeds United, West Bromwich Albion versus Leeds. Already a pretty tough fixture in my opinion. But yeah, looking forward to it, and it's my first official BHBN radio commentary assignment for, you know, calling a West Bromwich Albion game. So a little bit nervous, looking forward to it though, up for the challenge. And yeah, you know, it's really going to be good. And yeah, so Leeds United not done particularly well the two games that they've played this season. Obviously, like us, being knocked out in midweek of the Carabao Cup, a 3-0 defeat to Middlesbrough. Of course, we got knocked out by Fleetwood 2-1. But as I said in the preview to this game, I'm not worried about the Carabao Cup. You know, the focus is on the league, so this match is probably more important. The team selection for the Fleetwood game was probably influenced by this game today, because a lot of key players were missing from Tuesday's game. So yeah, it's going to be an interesting one today. Leeds United, as I said, going out the Carabao Cup like we did, and they ended up needing a last minute equaliser last weekend against Portsmouth. 3-3 draw there, but Leeds had to come from behind to get the point. So they are vulnerable. They have lost quite a few key players. The pressure is on Daniel Farke, and I think this weekend they're going to lose another one in Jorginho Rutter, whose release clause has been activated by Brighton and Hove Albion. So he could be heading to the Premier League and to the Amex Stadium with Brighton. So yeah, Daniel Farke probably losing another one of his key players. So we'll keep an eye on that one for you guys. But yeah, in terms of us, great win last weekend to kick things off, a 3-1 win at Loftus Road against QPR. Really happy about that. Can we make it 6 out of 6? Well, 6 points out of 6. I'm hoping so. But my prediction today is a 1-1 draw. I will be happy with a 1-1 draw against Leeds United. To be honest, it'll keep the momentum going. 4 points wouldn't be so bad from the first two games. And yeah, it's really going to be an interesting one, guys. If you like this video, then please leave a like, subscribe to Crazy Shadow Talks Football if you haven't already done so, and don't forget to hit that bell icon to join the Shadow Squad and get notified on all new content on the channel. It is just gone like 10 to 10. Obviously it's an early kickoff, it's a 12:30 kickoff, so I'm heading to the Hawthorns now to do all my media stuff first. And as a fire truck comes past me, sorry about that, guys. joys of trying to do the intro while you're heading to the Hawthorns. But yeah, got to do all the media stuff, all the media prep. You know, I've got my equipment in my bag now, so yeah, getting ready for it. Getting ready for the first official assignment as a BHBN radio employee. Don't forget, guys, you can listen to this. Well, you can't listen to this because this video goes out after the game, but you can listen to future commentary on BHBN radio at bhbn.net. That's where all the commentary will be. Or if you're unlucky enough to be in one of the many hospitals, so Samwell General, City Hospital, Heartlands Hospital, I think Solihull as well, you know, then obviously BHBN covers those hospitals as hospital radio. So yeah, and if you are in one of those hospitals right now, get well soon, guys. Get well soon. Whatever the ailments are, you know, we are stronger, and you know, you can fight this. So yeah, and special mention to Davin and Caroline, because obviously Caroline has got my season ticket right now, so she's heading to the Hawthorns with Davin, and yeah, I'm hoping to catch them sometime before the game for a pre-match interview, but there's no guarantees with how busy I'm probably going to be with all the media stuff. So yeah, hoping for at least a point from me. Ben, Kim and Stephen from the Super Switch programme on Ben's show, they've all backed West Brom to win. Ben's predicting 2-0 to West Brom, and both Kim and Stephen are predicting 2-1. So yeah, really interesting. They're backing the Albion. I'm being a little bit more realistic here because it is Leeds. So yeah, thanks so much, guys, for watching this video. I may not get a chance to say that at the end of this video, so I'm saying it now. And yeah, heading to the Hawthorns now. Come on, Albion. Boing, boing.
Here we are, guys, back at the Shrine. Here in the media suite, guys, overlooking the pitch. Beautiful. Alright, guys, here in the media suite, ready to start the day with a full English, courtesy of the football club. So yeah, loving it. And a free programme and a coffee as well. Awesome.
Alright, guys, John here. Just adding a little bit to this part of the video. Basically, while I was in the media suite, I was chatting to a lot of people. I've seen Andy Johnson. I've seen the legend that is Chris Brunt as well. And, you know, getting some insights there. But there was one guy I want to mention. I promised him a shout out. George, who I chatted to earlier in the media suite. We had a really nice chat. He spoke about how he lives in both the UK and Australia. He spends like a few months here, and you know, he resides in Australia for most of the year. He's a massive Albion fan. He's followed the Albion for decades, and he was chatting to me about what support was like in the 70s and 80s for West Bromwich Albion. Now, of course, I was born in the 1980s, so I was too young to remember that. And obviously, the 1970s, I weren't even born anyway. So I wouldn't know. But it was really great to get an insight from George as to what support was like in the 70s and 80s and how much the Hawthorns itself has changed since then. I know I've seen old photos of the Hawthorns and the old Woodman pub up in the Woodman corner between the Brummy Road end and the East End. But yeah, to actually, you know, speak to someone who's from that kind of era, who's not my parents, by the way, was a really great insight. And I just want to thank George. He does watch these vlogs on this channel, as well as he mentioned that he watches other West Bromwich Albion vloggers as well, you know, because being in Australia, he doesn't get to go to very many games. And he came to this one today, you know, because he managed to get travel and everything like that. He was over it. This is the part of the year where he spends in the UK anyway. So, yeah, he told me how he watches West Brom Fan TV, All Things Midlands, Will Burford, and, of course, myself, Crazy Shadow Talks Football. So, yeah, thank you, George, for the insights. And now, back to the video.
All right, guys, here outside the Hawthorns, and I've met up with Darren and his girlfriend, Caroline.
Fiancé,
my apologies.
No worries.
So, yeah, guys... New season, back at the Hawthorns. Feels good, doesn't it?
Oh, it does.
Yes.
Especially for your first match back.
Yeah, I haven't been to the ground in 5 years.
Yeah. And in part, it's thanks to me because I'm upstairs, so you've got my season ticket. Yeah. So, yeah. Anytime, Kaz.
Thank you for giving me the opportunity, Jonathan.
Absolutely, absolutely. Yeah, no worries, guys, no worries. So, yeah, really good to be back at the Hawthorns. Great 3-1 win last week against QPR.
Oh yeah.
Could have done better against Fleetwood, I know, but like I said in the preview video, the Carabao Cup, I'm not really bothered about it. Were we ever going to win it in February?
Yeah.
You know, it'd have been nice considering that's when my birthday is, but you know, yeah, so how are you feeling about today, guys? Leeds United.
I know the few winnings we've had with Leeds, and most of them hasn't been that great.
Well, I remember 2020, New Year's Day 2020, where we scored in the first 30 seconds.
Yeah, we was
there. That was still a 1-1 draw, but
I'm still surprised about that.
Oh, yeah. I'd barely got the vlog going before we scored.
Yeah,
I remember that day.
Those was the days.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Pre-COVID. Pre-COVID.
Yeah.
Prediction, Darren?
I say 1-1.
1-1, same as me. I've said 1-1 as well.
I say 1-1 as well.
Yeah, we're all in agreement. 1-1 draw.
And I'm going for Josh Madger.
Josh Madger to get a fourth goal. He's top goal scorer of the league so far with his hat trick.
Absolutely. He's been in for a long injury.
Absolutely, yeah.
But I do feel sorry for his old club, Bordeaux,
yeah.
Massive financial issues.
They've
dropped down into, like, they've even lost their professional status.
That's tough on Bordeaux. I mean, with the financial issues, we know more than anyone, don't we?
Because they used to be a really good team in
they
France.
They did, yeah. Bordeaux was really big in France, so yeah. So 1-1 draws all around, you know.
Yeah.
I would absolutely take a point. It'll be a bonus if it's free.
Yeah, especially if it is.
If we win, the pressure's on Daniel Farke of Leeds, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know, a draw and a loss for a team like Leeds.
I mean, like a draw against Portsmouth.
A draw against Portsmouth. And they needed to come from behind to draw as well.
Yeah. That
last kick of the game, equaliser. Yeah. So, yeah. It'll be tough on Daniel Farke if they lose this game, but let's hope we get something out of it. Alright, can I get an Up the Albion, guys?
Up the Albion!
Vikings!
Come on, guys, let's go.
Alright, guys, here, back in the media suite at the Hawthorns. Team sheet has just come through. Alex Palmer in goal, Darnell Furlong, Carl Bartley captain, Semi Ajayi, Jason Malumbi, Josh Madger after the hat-trick last week, John Swift, Torbjorn Heggem, Carlin Grant, Alex Moat and Tom Fellows. They start the game. Subs are Joe Wildsmith, Jed Wallace, Grady Diangana, Caleb Taylor, Ousmane Diakite, Lewis Dobbin, Paddy McNair, Gianluca Fabrotta and Diavanti Cole. They're the subs. For Leeds, they've got Ilian Messler, Jaden Bogle, Junior Firpo, Ethan Ampadu, captain, Pascal Stuick, Joe Rodden, Dan James, Joe Parole, Matteo Joseph, Wilfred Gonotto, and Ilya Grulev, and their subs are Cardalo, Joe Rothwell, Patrick Bamford on the bench, Brendan Aronson, who scored the equaliser at the end of their game against Portsmouth. Sam Byron, Joe Gelhard, James DiBio, Max Wober, and Charlie Crew. Referee Sam Allison, and the assistants are Andrew Fox, Jonathan Hunt, and Adam Hezig as the fourth official. So, looking like a really strong lineup there, guys. Hopefully for a decent result with that. Carlos Corbran, obviously, the team selection affected the Fleetwood game, but that's fine. Come on.
Oh, heard are very loud Hawthorns, ready for the new season. And yeah, the transfers that have happened this window have been really good. I'm looking forward to seeing Diavante Cole. He's on the bench today, so is Usmane Diakite, both on the bench. And Torbjorn Heggen, who's done really well so far, set up a goal for Josh Badger last weekend. Can he repeat the feat here today and set up some more goals? I'm sure every Baggies fan would love to see that as well. But with the rest of the team, the starting lineup today is Alex Palmer in goal, as always. Darnell Furlong, Kyle Bartley, Shemi Ajayi, Jason Malumbi, Josh Badger, fresh from that hat-trick last weekend against QPR, John Swift, Torbjorn Heggen, Carlin Grant, Alex Moat and Tom Fellows. On the bench today, Joe Wildsmith, Jed Wallace, who's probably coming back off an injury, that's why he's not being risked in the starting 11. We've got Brady Diangana back, Caleb Taylor, Usmane Diakite, Lewis Dobbin, Paddy McNair, Gianluca Flabotta and Diavante Cole. Very strong lineup there, but then again, Leeds, you cannot discount them, can you? Their starting lineup is Ilian Messila, Jaden Bogle, Junior Furpo, Ethan Ampadu, captain, Pascal Strumick, Joe Bowden, Dan James, Joel Perreault, Matteo Joseph, Wilfred Ganotto, and Ilya Rufek. On their bench, Carl Darlow, Joe Rothwell, Patrick Bamford, Brendan Amundsen, Sam Byron, Joe Gilhart, James DeBayo, Max Rover, and Charlie Drew. Again, strong lineup, but they are now missing Jorginho Butter, that comes off like Semi Ajayi or Carl Bartley into the goal. Let's hope that happens now. But yeah, here's Darnell Furlong with the long throw. Jaden Bogle. Free kick here, which John Swift looks to take. It's a little bit of a tight angle to go for goal, but we do have Carl Bartley and Semi Ajayi up here, as well as Darnell Furlong on the near post. Torbjorn Heggen is in the box as well, along with Josh Madja. So yeah, goal taken! Oh! Expected the keeper to get a touch on that. That's probably why he didn't expect it to hit him in the chest and go wide. Yes, hello everyone. Leeds have tried the long ball themselves, but it's gone out harmlessly for West Bromwich Albion for a throw. Darnell Furlong to take this. It's in the defensive half, so it's not one of his classic long throws. He's looking for options here. He's asking people to push up here. Leeds United marking very well, it's got to be said, all game. So yeah, he tries to get the throw, Darnell Furlong, up to Josh Madger. It doesn't quite come off. But Albion have the ball now with John Swift, and he's wide to Tom Fellows, who's got acres of space here. Needs a little bit of work to control the ball, and now he's on the ascendancy, cutting into the middle. Passes to Jason Malumbi, and then wide to Hegum, who 1-2s back to Malumbi. It's all about possession football at the moment for West Brom, because Leeds United have done some brilliant work in possession. Ajay tried to get the ball to Grant, but it was blocked by Wilfred Ganotto, who gets it wide on the right hand side, and now it goes back to Joe Gordon. There's a couple of boos going around the Hawthorns at the moment, because the fans feel that Leeds United are there for the taking. Yeah, and on top of that, if he had failed the challenge altogether, Donnell Furlong was through for a cross there. Yeah, he was in there. So Alex Moat again on this side of the Smedic End and West End corner. A lot of yellow shirts in the box. In fact, every Leeds player is in the box. Headed out to only as far as John Swift. Alex Moat crosses. Can someone get ahead to that? It goes over everyone. Josh Maggio has to recycle it. He gets another cross in, but there's no one there to meet the ball there, and it goes out for a Leeds United throw. Good pressure there from Albion. It's buoyed up the Hawthorns crowd here, and you can feel a goal coming. Absolutely. Yeah. It's one of those where you don't want it too close to the goalkeeper, but you want to get your guys to connect with the ball. So, it was one of those where it was just that fine line between neither. Yeah. It seemed that way anyway, and it went out for a Leeds throw, which Sturrock takes, tries to get it upfield, but Carl Bartley does well to put the pressure on, and Matteo Joseph heads it out. Donnell Furlong with a quick throw, goes back to Semi Ajay, who then goes back to Bartley. Now back to Ajay, and then all the way back to Alex Palmer. It's all about possession football at the moment for West Bromwich Albion. So they're trying to slow the tempo right down and basically give the strikers and the midfielders time to get into decent positions. Leeds about to take this corner on the corner of the Brummie Road, and a decent save there, it looked like, by Alex Palmer. Just punched the ball out, but Leeds recycle it, get it back in, and West Brom clear. Survive that. John Swift to Tom Fellows, and it is now a West Bromwich Albion throw about halfway inside the defensive half in front of the East Stand. And yeah, West Bromwich Albion just absorbing a little bit of pressure at the moment, trying to get on the attack. Likewise, Leeds trying to slow the pace down themselves this time, much to the annoyance of their own fans, it seems. Here comes Jason Malumbi, who gets it through to Josh Maggio, but he's out of position a little, has to go back to Tom Fellows, and then all the way back to Torbjørn Hegum, who's fighting. He's got about three Leeds players behind him, and now West Brom have a free kick just inside the attacking half on the far side in front of the East End. Again, the Leeds fans do not like that decision. But yeah, it's basically like three Leeds players to one West Brom player at the moment. We just can't seem to get anything going because Leeds are pressing really, really hard, it's got to be said. John Swift was through there. I think it was John Swift, or it could have been Jason Malumbi, was through if that ball was a little bit better. But now West Bromwich Albion have another throw-in, and it is again Darnell Furlong territory. The way the players are moving, I can tell that Darnell Furlong's going to launch this one into the box. Every Leeds player is inside their own box. We've got about four West Brom players outside the box ready to collect. Leeds do get it away, and it's a Leeds throw. Darnell Furlong just about stopped that from becoming any more dangerous. Yeah, Leeds United, every man in the box, and of course they defend well. Junior Firpo with the throw here, waiting to look for options of his own, which he does. And he tried to find Joe Perreault, who does get it through, but Jason Malumbi does get it all the way back to Alex Palmer safely, who then passes it to Jason Malumbi. Good ball there, and the keeper has to kick it out for a very promising West Bromwich Albion throw-in. That was a chance there. Furlong on this side calling for it as well, but he goes inside to Colin Grant chases, but the Leeds defender tries to get the ball away. It's Pascal Struick that's fighting with Colin Grant, and Grant did well to limit the clearance there, but obviously the ball was passed back to Colin Grant and he had to leave it because he was coming back from an offside position. Josh Madger tries to get the ball from Ethan Ampadu but fails. And Higgum with a nice defensive header up to John Swift. The tempo has ramped right up here at the Hawthorns. Now Tom Fellows with the cross, tries to get it, but it's blocked by Jaden Bogle. The one time that Jaden Bogle does engage Tom Fellows after his yellow card, and it's now out for a Leeds United throw. Chanting for a red card here for the Firpo. Yeah. Malumbi is still on the ground being treated by the physios. Firpo is still remonstrating with the West Brom physios actually. Yeah. Arguing with the physios, that's the first one.
Yeah. Physio getting physical with the photo.
Yeah. Now, just noticing down by the touchline, Carlos Corbett getting the rest of the squad. Tom Fellows is there, Colin Grant is there, Higgins there, Swift is there, and Semi Ajayi just getting some instructions here in this break in play. But yeah, did Firpo get a yellow card there? Gave a yellow card to someone, it's probably going to be Firpo, I'm not sure. We'll let you know as soon as we know, BHBN audience. But yeah, just a little break in play while Malumbi gets some attention It is a West Brom free kick, and yeah, Jason Malonga is going to take this free kick. It's short to Alex Moat. Just trying to slow the pace down a little bit now, recover from that. Now it's with Carl Bartley, who passes back to Moat. Carl Bartley and Alex Moat doing a little bit of a passing game themselves here, passing back and forth, to be honest. And yeah, Carl Bartley launches it up towards Darnell Furlong, who just about keeps it in. But Carlin Grant couldn't get the resulting header. And now Malumbi, not Malumbi, Moat. Yeah, it was Malumbi. It was Malumbi who was wrestling there. And the referee did not like that one bit. It's now a Leeds free kick. For the first half, 0-0. It's still looking like to be a half-time score. But here comes Alex Palmer with the goal kick. And that's it for the first half. West Bromwich Albion 0, Leeds United 0. Really, both teams had chances. You know, Josh Madger getting amongst it as well. You know, there's a bit of afters between Firpo and Malumbi. You know, that's a battle to look for in the second half. Also, Bogle on his yellow card, and Tom Fellows one to look out for as well. But all in all, pretty even game, 50-50. And yeah, West Bromwich Albion 0, Leeds United 0. Were defending well. We've now got a West Bromwich Albion corner to be taken, I think, by I'm not sure who it is. I've kind of got my observation blocked here. John Swift, yeah. To Malumbi, and in, like you said, anywhere else but the keeper, and that would have been 1-0 West Brom. Magic tried the flick there, but there was no blue and white shirt, there was only a yellow shirt to block it. But yeah, Alex Moat gets the ball back for West Bromwich Albion, and there back to John Swift. there's the danger as well, given the result of last weekend for Leeds. Amundsen capable of scoring late winners or equalisers, such as the case of last weekend. So, yeah, danger is there now with Amundsen and Joe Rothwell as well. So dangerous, that was so far down the pitch from a Leeds perspective, that would have been dangerous if he managed to get that ball into one of their strikers in the box. Now Alex Palmer slowing everything down, passes to Malumbi, who then passes to Ajoy, who then passes back to Alex Palmer, and now Bartley. They're just trying to get out of the defensive box here, which they do. Semi Ajoy forward to Carlin Grant, but couldn't get that. A Leeds player manages to kick it back down towards the Smevic end, which is where they are shooting towards now. And Jason Malumbi with the ball now, just trying to work out options again, you know, try and get this tempo calmed down a little bit, because at the moment the momentum is with Leeds United. Absolutely, it's on a knife edge at the moment. West Bromwich Albion 0, Leeds United 0. John Swift goes down, it's a free kick to West Bromwich Albion. Ethan Ampadu with the challenge. I'm not sure if the physios are coming on, he seems to be okay. Referee's checking on him, he's not calling for physios, so it doesn't look too serious. Just a little coming together between Ampadu and Swift. And this free kick is in a relatively dangerous position. I would say it's about 30, 35 yards out. It's actually closer to the halfway line than it is to the goal. So there's probably not a chance of a shot here. If there is, it would be the most spectacular goal ever. Goal of the season contender already if he attempted the shot, John Swift. But I don't think he's going to. He's going to be sensible about this. So we're just waiting, he's delaying the kick a little bit. The referee's whistle has gone. He's gone wide to Furlong and Major. Oh! I think Josh Major got the head to that, and I couldn't tell. He did, yeah. It looked like Josh Major was going to loop that. I don't know if he mishit that, but... Yeah, again, for the second time in this game, Carl Bartley has a shot, and I don't think he knew too much about it. But here come Leeds trying to get through, but Semi Ajoy does get the ball to Alex Palmer. And unfortunately for the Albion, Alex Palmer does slice it horribly for a Leeds United corner. Pressure's on for West Brom here. No Leeds player advancing, and yeah, it was just a horrible slice by Palmer there to concede the corner. Thankfully nothing came out of it, but yeah, Palmer urging everyone up the pitch. He's going to take this goal kick on his own, and yeah, you can tell that the pressure is really on now to try and win the game. It looks like, as West Bromwich Albion get a free kick here, it looks like one goal will secure the 3 points here. It's looking more and more like that here today. It is a free kick to West Bromwich Albion. Again, end-to-end stuff here at the Hawthorns. As we await this corner, it looks like it's going to be Alex Mowat on the far side between the East Stand and the Brummie Road end. So everyone's in the box. There's a Leeds player on the floor, so the referee has to delay the corner. He's just going to have a word with, it looks like, Darnell Furlong. Yeah, Furlong and Ganotto. A little bit of afters there, which left Ganotto on the deck. So now the corner is allowed to be taken with Malumbi. And it's up, and the keeper gets a hand to it, punches it out, but it only goes as far as Tom Fallows, and the play has had to be stopped because there's a Leeds player on the floor just outside the goal mouth, and now their physios are coming on. The Hawthorns fans did not like that one bit, but obviously if it's a clash of heads, which it might be, then obviously play has to stop and the physios have to come on to treat the player because he's right, literally, he's almost in the goal itself on the floor. So there must have been a clash of heads. West Bromwich Albion now preparing a substitution, and it does look like Jed Wallace is coming on. He is for Carlin Grant. Carlin Grant comes off. Standing ovation for Carlin Grant from the Hawthorns crowd. But Jed Wallace is on the field of play. It looked like it could have been a clash of heads to me. And as I said at the top of the show, if Leeds don't get anything from the Hawthorns today, then all the pressure is going to be on Daniel Farke as Leeds United boss, because as one of the stronger teams in the league, especially now with the likes of Leicester and Southampton going up from the Championship, Leeds have always been one of the bookies' favourites for promotion this season. So along with that, the pressure comes with that. Now, yeah, Ampadu is coming off with the physios and play will resume shortly. Yeah, Patrick Bamford has that kind of reputation. You know, he likes to mix it in, to be honest, and yeah, he's not afraid to dish it out, Patrick Bamford. What he's doing, but he passes back to Malumbi and then back to Mowat. So there was a little bit of a spark there from Furlong, but he decided there was no one going up with him, so he had to pass back. And now it's with Ajayi, then back to Malumbi. And it's just a case of, we're just trying to, you know, outmaneuver Leeds United at the moment, like force them to come out of position and come to the ball while we have possession, so that we can then expose the space behind and hopefully get that elusive opening goal. Yeah, Darnell Furlong gets that ball back after some good work from Jason Malumbi, who then receives the ball back from Furlong. Again, just trying to work the space, but Leeds United do well on the press. So it has to come back to Semi Ajayi, who then passes it to Swift and then back to Bartley. Over to Malumbi, who's trying to release Tom Fellows, but that's going to be too high for the youngster. And it's out for a Leeds United throw-in, which Ganotto passes to one of his teammates. Can't see who it is. But yeah, that was a little bit wayward from West Bromwich Albion there. It's a nice idea to try and get it to this side with Tom Fellows. He does have the pace, and Bogle, don't forget who's man-marking him, is on a yellow. So it is a nice avenue, but it just didn't come off there. Looks like a double substitution for West Brom. Thank you. Alex Palmer clears that. Good pressure there from Leeds, but Palmer gets it away. Comes all the way back to their goalkeeper, Messelay. And now Ganotto. No, it wasn't, but it managed to find its way to Ganotto. And again, Leeds United fans not happy that it's going all the way back to their goalkeeper. And Alisson's on the pitch as well, who scored that goal. So, yeah, that's what West Bromwich Albion have got to, you know, watch out for in the last 5 minutes plus added. Leeds United have coped with him better than what Queen's Park Rangers coped with him last weekend. Lewis Dobbin, interesting to see what he can do for West Brom, having been on loan from Aston Villa just down the road from here. And obviously Grady Diangana, he's been a mainstay for the past few seasons for West Bromwich Albion. His pace can, you know, create a lot of chances, and yeah, it'll be a new challenge for Leeds United's defences in Grady Diangana and Lewis Dobbin. Potential attack from Leeds United, and of course the West Bromwich Albion faithful appreciated that effort, but now it's back with Leeds with Ethan Ampadu passing it wide, but that's a wasteful pass from Leeds to straight to Malumbi, and yeah, Lewis Dobbin tries to make something of it, but it's a free kick to Leeds United, which West Bromwich Albion fans did not appreciate, to be honest, because it looked more 50-50 between Grady Diangana and the Leeds player, Wilfred Ganotto. Higham shoulder barges Vogel. Leeds are not happy with this, but play carries on. And now here comes Jed Wallace into the centre. Gets it wide to Jason Malumbi, who then in turn gets it wide to Donnell Furlong. Malumbi tries to find Lewis Dobbin, but it gets cut out by Leeds United. And again, Leeds United aren't happy with that, but they do get a free kick. It looked, it didn't look like much, but the Leeds United player is on the floor after a challenge from Jed Wallace. And now it's West Bromwich Albion fans' turn to not be happy with a decision there. 4 minutes added on, guys. 4 minutes added on. And this game at 0-0 is on a knife edge. Yeah, chance of you're not fit to referee from the West Bromwich Albion faithful. But it ran timely to Alex Palmer. That's probably the worst I've seen of Patrick Bamford in all his career. That pass, it was good from an Albion perspective, but it was terrible, like, overall, that pass. And now Leeds United get a free kick. Patrick Bamford brought down inside the centre circle, and it is end to end. I mean, West Bromwich Albion are trying to break, but Leeds United defending resiliently. Likewise, Leeds United tried to get on the break, and West Bromwich Albion doing well defensively as well. It's kind of like that the West Bromwich Albion team and Leeds United team are cancelling each other out at the moment. Shield that ball then and make sure it went the way of West Bromwich Albion. Not much left in this game now, still 0-0. If there is going to be a goal, it's got to happen now, be it for West Bromwich Albion at the Brummie Road end or for Leeds United at the Smerwick end. But Alex Palmer boots that out into the attacking half of the pitch for West Bromwich Albion. Hegum gets it wide to Tom Fellows, who then tries to shimmy away, does well against Gonotto. And then there's a push there. But, yeah, originally the referee was not going to give that, but he gives the free kick to Leeds United, actually. I thought it went the other way to West Bromwich Albion, but Ethan Ampadu looked to be bundled over by Tom Fellows. Yeah, like for like change really. You know, Diakite on for Malumbi. So yeah, just trying to see this game out now. And that free kick from Leeds was about as wasteful as you can get. It's come right out on this side for a West Bromwich Albion throw, and the Leeds United fans in the Smerwick end just did not appreciate that, to be honest. Hegum now with the throw, just delaying it a little bit until West Bromwich Albion players can get into position. Diakite with his first touch of the ball, heads it, but it goes to a Leeds United player. But then Dean Garner does well to first win the ball and then draw the foul. And it's a West Bromwich Albion free kick, which is taken quickly by Moat to Dean Garner, and now it's wide to Diakite, who then passes to Ajay. And I think it's a case of just seeing this game out now and getting the points. Like I said, if there was going to be a winner, it would only be like one goal. Leeds looked like scoring, Albion looked like scoring for long periods of that game. But in the end, you know, for the Albion, the first major hurdle has been overcome to get something out of this game. You know, I thought it might have been a draw before the game because I know how tough these two teams are. In the end, it was really a case of each team cancelling each other out. So yeah, I do see these two teams there and thereabouts in the playoffs promotion spots. So yeah, it's even on as even at the Hawthorns here on a Saturday afternoon, and all in all, a fair result, I think. I would have to say my man of the match is Tom Fellows. He did really well down the wing, and obviously, you know, the fact that Jada Vogel got booked pretty early in the game helped things. But he was one of the most creative influences we had today. And yeah, my man of the match award does go to Tom Fellows. Really good game he's had.
Guys, just left the Hawthorns. Probably the most entertaining 0-0 I'm ever going to call in my commentary career. And it was the first one. So, yeah, we didn't lose. That was the important bit. Leeds United, the first major hurdle of the season. I wouldn't say successfully negotiated, but we did negotiate it regardless. And, yeah, it's... In the end, it's a decent result. I think at the moment we are top of the championship with 4 points. That's probably dependent on the rest of the games today. But, you know, we haven't lost yet in the league. And, relatively pleased. I did say it was going to be a 1-1 draw. I will take a 0-0 at this early stage of the game, early stage of the season, rather. But yeah, really enjoyed that commentary. I know you could probably only hear one side of that, my side, because obviously, you know, it was so loud in there. Man, was it loud in the Hawthorns. So yeah, really pleased that well done Albion fans for that atmosphere, because, you know, that was electric, that atmosphere was. Leeds fans getting on their team's case a bit. Obviously, you know, they're not doing particularly well. That's two draws for them. 2 points from two games isn't good enough for a team like Leeds. But yeah, you know, really, really good for us. 4 points from six. I will happily take that after two games. All in all, a fair result, I think. West Bromwich Albion 0, Leeds United 0. First hurdle negotiated. Next week we're on to Stoke. Like I said, I'm probably going to be at the Stoke game. I've just got to hash a few things out over the next few days with the BHBN sports team, and obviously sort out my own travel to the Bet365 stadium. But if all goes to plan, I will be at Stoke versus West Brom next Saturday, 3 p.m. kickoff, with Paddy Silk, who's another member of the BHBN radio team. And hopefully I'll be able to do something similar to this. But obviously, being an away game, it all depends on, you know, the Stoke City officials, whether I'm allowed to do that. So yeah, all in all, it was a really surreal experience for me. First proper match commentary under my belt. Really happy about that. If only it could have been a little bit of a better result, but I will take a 0-0. I didn't want to be, you know, commentate my first game on a defeat. So yeah, it's a really great chance. And I hope you like the new format of the videos now, because obviously, you know, I'm not in the crowd anymore. I'm up in the gantry doing media work. So I hope that you enjoy these new videos, guys. If you like this video, then please, please, please leave a like. Subscribe to Crazy Shadow Talks Football if you haven't already done so. And don't forget to hit that bell icon and join the Shadow Squad and get notified on all new content on the channel. But for now, guys, West Bromwich Albion 0, Leeds United 0. It is a point to go with the three that we got from QPR. So, yeah, really, really enjoyable. And yeah, thanks so much for watching, guys. Bye for now.